Hello everyone and welcome to The Den. This week we are going to get into four of some of the best crock pot recipes on these long winter months when it's really cold outside. So let's get into that. So I have my menu board here and we're going to go over what we're having. Here's where I make my list, and tonight we're going to be doing chicken tortilla soup, then loaded baked potato soup, creamy chicken tortilla soup, and creamy chicken and noodles to round off our videos for this week. So we're going to go to the store and we're going to pick up the things that are on the list for what we need for this week. So let's get going. I'm kind of in a rush, so if it seems like I'm rushing, it's probably because I am, because my oldest son is staying with my two youngest sons, who are both sick with the same cold I have. So I'm going to kind of blast the store so I can get back really fast. And the store is not too far away, so he can handle it for half an hour or so. So let's go shopping. Okay, so one of the items on our list for this week is celery. Now this is already cut at the bottom, so it doesn't have the stalk on it. You're gonna pay way more for that. You're still gonna have to cut these. So you can see here that the price of this is $2.72. Down here we have just the full stalk. It has the end on it. It's only $1.72. So 100% I'm gonna find the best one of these for a dollar less. Let's do that. Celery is always dirty. I don't know why. Every time I get it, it's filthy. This one actually looks pretty good. So sometimes you'll just see like mud in the bag. It's disgusting. But this one looks good, so we're gonna go with this one. All right, same with carrots. If you buy the full, these are 67 cents compared to this, that would be $2.44, or this, that's $1.24. Buy them whole, cut them yourself. Just saves you money. Okay, so when you're looking for spinach, baby spinach will always be more expensive. This spinach does have a bit more of a spinachy taste, but I don't think when you're making the soup it makes that much of a difference. So I'm gonna grab one of these bags. Cool. They're probably left over from the holidays. What I do when I pick out my potatoes is I just make sure they don't feel soft. So in the cart they go. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and pick up chicken thighs and some chicken breasts. Now I'm gonna get the Walmart brand just because it's cheaper than buying your own brand. Sometimes a lot cheaper. I'm also gonna pick up chicken breasts and figure out chicken breasts are cheaper than chicken thighs. I don't know how that's possible. Okay, so I was gonna pick up, gonna make tortellini soup. I was gonna pick up the tortellinis here, but I've never tried any of these and I'm afraid they would taste like gross. So I'm gonna run to Sam's at a later time. So that would be on your list for these recipes, but I'm not getting it here. Okay, so heavy cream is on the list and it is kind of an expensive purchase. This is $5. You can definitely switch out for milk. This will make it a little bit more creamier and I like using this, but if you are on a tight budget, just use milk. It'll work just fine, or a can of like cream of mushroom soup or extra one. So this is going to the cart. Okay, so I ordered a cheese grater. I don't know if you've seen what's on top of it, but I'm gonna start using block cheese, but for now I don't have it yet. So I was looking here and I saw only sharp cheddar and I got sad, but look. One more, and I buy the big bag because we go through it and it lasts a long time. Obviously, if you're going to buy on a budget and it's only a couple of you, buy a smaller pack. Alright, so these are like the best tortilla chips on a budget, and I get the party size because my kids eat these just randomly. So I'm gonna get three bags. You would only need one or even a smaller one, but this is going in the cart. Okay everyone, so we just got back from the store and I ended up spending about $102. I had to get fruit and a couple things for lunch for the week for the kids. So $102 for me is pretty good. The biggest things were like the cheese, that was like $17, and then the chicken was like $24 or $25 between the both that I got. When you're budgeting, always buy, you know, how much you think you'll need. Obviously that makes the most sense. But also think about too, like when I buy the chicken thighs, I know that I'm gonna use that tray of chicken thighs for more than one meal. So it is cheaper to buy the big tray than the smaller ones if I'm gonna use that throughout the week. And always check your dates so that they're not like going bad on you midweek. Okay, so we are going to actually start getting our meal prepared for the week. And the first one that we're gonna make this week is chicken tortilla soup. So let's get started doing that. Okay guys, so these are my ingredients here. All of this stuff I already had on hand. I did not have to buy any of this because as I was planning out my meals for this week, I wanted to use as much as I already had on hand. So we have garlic, which I keep this on hand all the time, two onions, some chicken broth, my taco seasoning. We'll also be using some garlic, onion, and cumin as well in this recipe. I have black beans. I have a can of corn, which will go in at the end. I won't put this in straight away because sometimes corn will give your food a sweet flavor, so I'm gonna wait until like the last half an hour to dump this in. We have our green chilies. I have a large can, and I also have a can of diced tomatoes. Now you can combine these and buy just a can of Rotel. I find Rotel to be a little bit spicy. My kids tend to think it's a little spicy. Also, I just grabbed this out of the fridge. I'm going to use a little bit of this salsa verde. This makes it have really, really good flavor. So if you have some of this on hand, it's not 100% necessary, but it does increase the flavor. It makes it better, I think. So also not shown here will be your garnishes, like your tortilla chips or your tortilla strips, whatever you plan to use. You don't have to use any of that. Cheese, sour cream, and green onion. I also have a few avocados tonight that I'll put with it. Some people like avocados, some don't. But I need to use them, so tonight we'll smash those up and we'll use that with this recipe as well. If you are looking to stretch this meal and you have a lot of people to feed and you don't have a huge budget, you can always put your soups over rice. I know that sounds kind of weird, but it actually will take the flavor of the soup to rice well. If you put the rice on the bottom of your bowl and then add your soup on top, I think that that's a good way to stretch any soup, especially if you're on a tight budget. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna chop up these onions and we're gonna get the stuff in the pot so I can get cooking for the rest of the day. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start putting my stuff into my crock pot. I'm going to use half of this tray of chicken. I think I'm gonna use three. There looks like there's about seven. I'm gonna use three breasts. That's good. I'm gonna put this away and wash my hands. Okay, next up is gonna be our onion. I did two small onions. One large onion would be fine too. Get that in there. I'm gonna go ahead and put in, I'm gonna start with one can of chicken broth. That'll probably be enough. All right, so we're gonna do one and a half tablespoons of garlic. And when we get done with this recipe, I will break down portion sizes for you and tell you how many this is going to feed. So hold on for that. These are my seasoned black beans. I'm throwing them in with the juice. Two cans. This is a large can of green chilies. It is the 7 ounce. They do have smaller cans. One can of diced tomatoes. Sometimes I don't put the tomatoes in there. You can get away without those. So if you don't have diced tomatoes on hand, it's not crucial, but it does add some flavor. I'm gonna give about that much, which is about probably 2 teaspoons of taco seasoning. I'm gonna add some granulated onion. At least a teaspoon of that. Same with your granulated garlic. Okay. We got some cumin here. A little goes a long way. I would say half teaspoon to a teaspoon is all you need. Okay, our last ingredient is going to be our salsa verde. I use this brand, Herdez. It's the best in my opinion. You don't have to add this ingredient. I think it makes it so much better. Measure with your heart. I am doing, I don't know, probably like a cup. And then get your spoon out and I just mix this. Try to incorporate all of these spices and what's not into here. And there you have it. We're gonna let this cook all day long. So let's go ahead and get this set. Okay, so I'm gonna set the timer, turn it on. I'm gonna set mine to low. And I'm gonna time it for about 7 hours and 45 minutes. And there we go. We'll see how this turns out. Okay, so one of the ingredients I added was this salsa verde. You could use red salsa, you can use enchilada sauce, like if you had a can of the green enchilada or the red enchilada sauce, you could throw that in there too, and that would be really good too. I've done that before. So it's very versatile. Anytime you cook in a crock pot, I think for the most part, like especially with something like this, it's super versatile. So you can switch out some ingredients, like the black beans. You could definitely use a different type of beans for this, pinto beans, or like at the end, I may, if I want to thicken this soup up, I'll probably add a can of refried beans, which I did not show. But I am feeding on any given day between 5 to 10 people. It just depends on who's here and who's going to be eating dinner. So tonight I think we'll only have five people eating at dinner time, but there may end up being 3 bowls that we set aside for the other people that live in the house. So if you are trying to make this for your family and you're only a family of say 3, 4, or 2, just cut the recipe in half or in a, you know, by the quarter. Like I would use, if it was just my daughter and her husband live in Alaska. So if she was making this just for the two of them, I would tell her only to use 2 chicken breasts or 1.5 if she wanted to get really frugal, and 1 can of beans. And I would just tell her to just reduce the amounts that she uses, so, 'cause she doesn't need to feed 8 people. So that's my little tidbits for that. And again, this is for going to serve 8 people at minimum. So keep that in mind when you're making your recipes that I make for a lot of people, but you can definitely cut this in half. Alrighty guys, so we have about 45 minutes left and I'm gonna add my can of corn here. I'm also going to add a can of refried beans because sometimes I'll do that. Like I'll just decide that it needs something else, and feel free to add it, feel free not to, it doesn't matter. It's not gonna make or break. But the spoon holder has actually worked out okay. So I'm gonna take the lid off. So this is the low setting on the crock pot and it's at a simmer here. So it's been like that for quite some time. So I don't think the high, I don't know. I read reviews that people said that the high did burn. So I'm not sure how the high setting will do. I am going to test it out eventually, but this is what it's looking like. At about 2 hours left on the clock, I shredded the chicken. So you can see it looks really good. And I also gave it a taste test just to make sure. I did add a smidge more taco seasoning. But here's what it's looking like. So I'm gonna go ahead and add those 2 things in, give it a stir, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I added my 2 last ingredients in and here's what it's looking like now. Nice thick soup. Like I said, the refried beans give it a little bit of thickness and they add flavor, in my opinion. So you don't have to add those if you don't want to. It's not gonna make or break your dinner, but this is ready to go. I'm just gonna let it simmer for a little bit longer in here or finish cooking, and just so everything is heated through, and then we're going to eat. All right, so here we are plating. We're putting our soup in a bowl, and the only thing my kids complained about was corn, which I normally don't add. So that's why I say you can make this your own. That's, you know, key to cooking. Make it your own. Make it what your family likes. Normally I don't add corn, but here we are with some sour cream, some chopped green onion, some avocado, and some shredded cheese. It's optional. You don't have to have these toppings, but they make it great. And tortilla chips at the table. Now we're going in for day 2. And right here you see me sauteing some butter. I'm just gonna show you exactly how I make this. You do not have to do this part. You can just add your ingredients in, but this is how I make it. If I didn't have this saute setting in my Ninja, I would be doing this on the stove. But it's just something I've always done. You can just throw your ingredients in the pot. You don't even have to have this butter. If you don't want to add butter in, don't do that. It's fine. Now I am going to warm up this bacon crumble. I'm using crumble. You could feel free to use cooked, just sliced bacon that you chopped up. That would work just fine too. I like the crumble bacon because it's nice and small, and I think it does well for the soup. So here I am just releasing some of the fat from the bacon so that I can saute my onion. Again, unnecessary I would not use raw bacon in this. You want to have that cooked bacon. Here's my onion and my cat. Now I'm going to remove the bacon from the pan. And as I'm removing the bacon from the pan here, I am letting the grease kind of fall back into the pan because that's how I'm going to saute my onion. I'm just showing you how I make the soups. So you don't have to do it this way. You could just add all your ingredients in at once and that would be just fine. But this is how I do it. And I'm just going to stick with what I know, what's good. So now we are going to go ahead and add in that onion. And I'm just going to saute that. I kind of like that the Ninja Foodie does have that option to saute. It's nice. So here it is, it's translucent, looks great. The next thing that we are going to get ready is our chicken broth. And we're gonna go in with our first can. Oh, I added the bacon back in here. So add your bacon back in once your onion is good, or just add the onion and the bacon in and then your broth. So here we go. I'm going to add in four cans of broth. So this is going to feed at least 8 people. So if you are feeding 2 to 4, just go in with 2. Half the amount of bacon. I think I used about 1.5 cups of bacon crumble there. So 1/2 cup to 3/4 cup of bacon crumble and a small onion. That'd be fine. 2 cans of broth. All right, now we're gonna go on with our granulated onion. I measure with my heart. That's at least, I'd say, a teaspoon, so reduce it by 1/2. Same with the granulated garlic. Next up, oregano. 1/4 teaspoon to 1/2 teaspoon would be just fine. Potatoes. It's magical. And in they go to the pot. I'm using fresh potatoes. Feel free here to use canned potatoes. I would be using 4 to 5 cans if I were making this right now of canned potatoes. And so I would say use 2 cans of canned potatoes if you're reducing this by 1/2. I have the mindset of making a lot all the time. I've just always had to do that with a large family. So that was at least 7 to 8 potatoes there. And we're just going to give this a stir. And this is the base, the foundation of your soup. Set that crock pot on low for 6 hours. I would say make this on a day that you're home. Because you want to, if you're going to use fresh potatoes, you want to make sure that they're not overcooking. 1/2 cup of cream goes into the pot in the last 1/2 hour. Make sure your potatoes are cooked before you add this ingredient. And I'm just going to give that a stir. And we're going to come in with the secret ingredient here that I did not talk about yet. And that is potato flake. So you can feel free to use potato flake to thicken up your soup or pull out some of those cooked potatoes, mash them up, I'd say at least 1/2 cup of them, and reintroduce them back into your soup. And that will add thickness. But the potato flake, if you have it on hand, it really does add thickness. The perfect amount of thickness. You will always use potato flake. It doesn't alter the flavor. My husband will not eat imitation or potato flake, whatever it's called. He does not like them, but he doesn't notice it in this soup. So just with the potato flake, the key here is to add a little stir, wait for it to see if it's gonna thicken, and then add more. So you can see here, we're at the right amount of thickness. It's looking really good. And then do not forget your cheese, because that is your finishing touch. Makes the flavor amazing. And I love cheese, so. Just gonna stir that in, and then it's gonna be ready to plate. And then we're just gonna put that in our bowl. You can see how nice and thick that soup is. Came out great, as usual. And now we're going to just add a little bit of that green onion that I had left over from the chicken tortilla soup. And some more shredded cheese if you wish. Neither of these are required, but makes it good. And there we have it. Now we're gonna move on to day 3, which is our chicken tortellini soup. And I'm adding in six chicken thighs. And I'm not making as much of this. You could actually do just about 4 thighs and that would be fine too. It's gonna be very chickeny, but you could reduce the amount of thighs that you're using here. And I had a whole can of broth there, a whole carton. Actually, it was about 1/2 of a carton, I'm sorry. So 1 can of broth. Added a whole onion that I did not saute. Some granulated onion and granulated garlic. half teaspoon to a teaspoon of each black pepper to your taste. And some oregano, half teaspoon or so. And then we're going to set that to low for 6 hours. And at about the 2 to 3 hour mark, we're going to come back in and shred that chicken up. You can see here that the onion is nice and soft too. And I have this little nifty tool. But I'm only feeding 4 to 5 people tonight with this. So last half an hour, add in about a cup of cream or milk. Cream is going to make it creamier, but milk will work just fine here too if you did not have it on hand. It's fresh spinach, half a bag. Looks like a lot. It will reduce quite a bit. So we're going to add that spinach in there, and then we're going to give it a stir. Like I said, it looks like a lot, but I promise it will reduce down. Here's our tortellinis from Sam's Club. We're going to use about half. So that's about 12 ounces, but this is fresh tortellini. It's not frozen, so it's not going to need as much time to cook. So if you're using frozen tortellinis, make sure you give it enough time to cook. Parmesan cheese. This is going to add a really good flavor to this soup and also thickens it a bit. So I use probably half a cup. Feel free to use however much you wish. You can see there's a lot of chicken in here. I could have reduced my thighs by half, but I thought I was feeding more, so then I ended up not. So here we go, we're plating this up. Doesn't that look good? I love this soup. There it is, all bowled up. You don't have to add anything to the top, just like that. All right, so day 4, we are going in with our creamy chicken noodle soup. We have cream of chicken, carrots, chicken broth, celery, egg noodles. And here we're gonna start with our chop of our carrots, and our celery is gonna be next. Here we are going to add this to the pot. Now I do have this on my saute setting. Again, not necessary, just add these ingredients in. So in go the carrots. You could do 2 to 3 carrots. Half of a head of celery. I'm using a whole bunch of celery here. And I add that in. And then next up, we're going to go in with our onion. And I am going to be using 2 medium onions. 1 medium onion or a small onion would be fine too if you're going to reduce this by half. I am planning on feeding at least 8 with this amount. I'm going to give that a stir. Again, this is on my saute setting, but you don't have to do that part. Adding in our thighs, we have 3, 4, 5, 6. This was the rest of my tray of chicken thighs for that week, what we bought at the store. Okay, so chicken broth. I'm going to add 2 cartons of chicken broth here. So if you're reducing this by half, use 1 or 2 cans. We're going to need enough liquid here to add our noodles in later. We are going to come in with a little bit of cream at the end, but make sure you have a good liquid line here to account for your noodles later. Now we're going to add in that second carton. Get that in there. And now we're going to come in with 2 cans of cream of chicken. This is what's going to add most of the creaminess to your soup. This is, if you were just wanting to make regular chicken soup, don't add this part. If you didn't have it, it's fine. You could also do cream of mushroom soup. In goes the second one. And I'm going to give that a stir with my spoon here. Just incorporate all those ingredients. I try not to hit the bottom of my crock pot with that because it's a scratch, cooked scratch. But we're gonna have some black pepper here, oregano, half teaspoon, granulated garlic. I'm gonna go in with at least a teaspoon of that, maybe a little more, and granulated onion, and it poured out a lot there. So that's at least 1 to 2 teaspoons, but reduce that by half if you're reducing the recipe by half. Give that a stir, combine all those ingredients, set your crock pot to low for 6 hours. And then we're gonna go in with our egg noodles, and I'm using 2 cups. So again, reduced by half. And last half an hour, I'm going to add in my heavy whipping cream and the noodles at the same time. Right, the noodles are gonna need time to cook here. And my crock pot cooks pretty high, like a high temperature, even on the low setting. So Parmesan cheese here, just add a little bit, not too much. But my crock pot does cook kind of hot, so if you know how your crock pot cooks, account for the time that it will take to cook those noodles. I'm gonna make sure they're cooked through. Just adding that Parmesan cheese is optional. Now we're going to plate this up. I also made homemade bread for this. So that's going to be our garnish here at the end. But here we're putting it in the bowl. Look at that. It's delicious. And then here you have it with my homemade bread. And we're ready to eat. Okay, everyone, I really hope you enjoyed those four crockpot meals. I hope that you try them in your kitchen. Every single one turned out great, as they normally do. Those are just really good, homey, warm meals that you can have on a cold winter day. Really hits the spot, make some homemade bread, and they're just perfect. So I hope you enjoyed this video. So if you found value in these videos, please do me a favor and hit that subscribe button. It really helps this channel get into the algorithm and help populate these videos so it could reach more people out there. And I have a whole line of videos coming up that I hope that you will enjoy. So until next time, I'll see you in the next video.